keep informed. Stay plugged in. Read next on Sunday and every day of the week.
Hello and welcome. This is Next Business News. My name is Chinwe Chukwu. Dangote Group said it has liquidated a $1.27 billion loan facility obtained from a consortium of 10 Nigerian banks in May 2008 to finance its system division expansion project. The loan repayment schedule was to commence in August 2010, with the last repayment due in 2015. The repayment of the debt came as a big surprise to the industry watchers, as many of the expansion projects are still at their foundation level. But Aliko Dangote, president and chief executive of the Dangote Group, said the decision to repay the loan ahead of the scheduled plan is part of his policy to ensure that Dangote Cement does not owe any Nigerian bank. He said the group is embarking on the consolidation of its cement assets in line with its consolidation strategy. As part of efforts to transform the oil and gas industry in Nigeria, the federal government has organized a bilateral capacity building workshop between Nigeria and the United Kingdom. Participants in the workshop titled Nigeria-UK Government Energy Bilateral Capacity Building Support for the Oil and Gas Sector Reforms, which started in Abuja on Monday, were asked to acquire the necessary skills to drive and deliver the objectives of the oil and gas sector reform. In his opening address at workshop, the Minister of Petroleum Resources, Rehwan Lukman, said the program was very timely considering the ongoing reform in Nigeria's petroleum industry. Recent computer attacks on the mighty Google left every corporate network in the world looking a little less safe. Google's confrontation with China over government censorship in general and specific attacks on its systems is an exceptional case, of course, extending to human rights and international politics as well as high-tech spying. But the intrusion into Google's systems and related attacks from within China and other 30 companies point to the rising sophistication of such assaults and the vulnerability of even the best defenses, security experts say. The Google case shines a bright light on what can be done in terms of spying and getting into corporate networks, said Edward M. Strauss, a former high-tech crime agent with the FBI, who now heads the computer security investigation firm in New York. Thank you for watching. For more details on these and other stories, please visit our website, www.234.com. Thanks.
Keep informed. Stay plugged in. Read next on Sunday and every day of the week.